श्री नितिन गडकरी जी, somebody who was known for his excellent work in infrastructure right from the time he was a minister in the government of Maharashtra over 2 decades ago, when he did the impossible. He created roads of world-class quality, the Mumbai-Pune Expressway, when he created over 50 flyovers, which till today are the lifeline of Mumbai. Somebody who can be recognized as the infrastructure man of India. It's a privilege to be sharing the dais with him on this very important program. Amitabh Kant, CEO of Niti Aayog, somebody who works with a lot of passion, takes up a project and relentlessly pursues it until he succeeds. Happy to have you lead this initiative along with Quality Council of India and Adil Zainulbhai. Really comes with a rich array of experience with McKinsey. I'm also delighted that you have involved the National Institute for Chartered Program and Project Professionals. So we have a terrific combination, the Niti Aayog, NICPP and the QCI, working in tandem to come out with this wonderful document, which Honorable Minister Gadkari ji is going to release today. My congratulations to all of you for this collaboration to design the NP-NPF. And I have no doubt in my mind, this is going to transform the way Indian infrastructure projects are implemented. In fact, right after this call, after this virtual engagement, I have 3 reviews lined up. I'm reviewing the dedicated freight corridor, which I review every week. Then I'm reviewing the Kevadia line, which goes to the Statue of Unity. We have Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel's anniversary coming up on 31st. We are committed to completing the rail connectivity to the Statue of Unity by 31st December. Until last month, I was reviewing it every month. Now, because we are close to completion, I review it every 15 days. And the first station modernization cum development program at Gandhinagar, where we've set up a beautiful station and a 5-star hotel right outside Mahatma Mandir, where vibrant Gujarat is held and very important international engagements are held. That will also be commissioned in the next 2 months. Collectively, these 3 projects are going to be reviewed all through today evening. And I'm going to share my learnings out of your proposals and out of the work that your team has done to see how we can use that and engage in the railways with that. In fact, your document will really help in the systematic development of quality project management professional work. It's really the need of the hour in India, and we need to evolve better practices. We need to have much better systems in place. There can be absolutely no 2 doubts about it. And I'm sure government can leverage this framework that you have developed to bridge the gap between demand and supply of world-class professionals for managing projects, not only in India. I think we have a huge scope for sending our professionals to the rest of the world also and earn for our country a great name and great value. Nobody can deny that infrastructure is going to be the backbone of Atmanirbhar Bharat, the new India that we envisage, an India where everybody has access to quality infrastructure, where we have world-class ports, world-class airports, world-class railway system, world-class roadways, coastal and domestic inland waterways. All of this infrastructure collectively is going to help us bring down logistics costs, become more cost competitive internationally, and truly engage with the world, not on the back of subsidies and government giving us crutches, but on the back of our own competitive strength, on the back of our own ability to compete with any other country in the world when it comes to providing goods and services through greater engagement with the rest of the world. What are the good principles that really help us manage projects well and transform the way infrastructure is implemented in India. I'd like to share with you one small experience that I personally had with the Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi. I possibly mentioned it earlier to you, Adil Bhai, or to you, Amitabh Ji, but I'd like to share with all the colleagues on this call my own experience of January 2015. On the 5th of January 2015, we had launched the Ujala program, under which we had planned that over the next 4.5 years, we will introduce LED bulbs in a big way in the country. And the target was, and believed to be an impossible target, that we will replace 770 million, that is 77 crore LED incandescent bulbs. You know, the old incandescent bulbs, they are called, I think, Lattus or something in Hindi. Those old bulbs we were replacing with LED bulbs. We set a target of 77 crore in 4.5 years. And mind you, before Prime Minister Modi's government came in, our company, which was spearheading this project, EESL, was only doing 6 lakh bulbs in a year. 1 year, 6 lakh bulbs. Target Prime Minister set before us, 77 crore in 4.5 years. We launched it on 5th January. Project was being rolled out. Idea was to bring down cost, make it to such large scale that it becomes very competitively priced and all Indians can replace it, so that we bring down carbon emissions and bring down energy consumption. Every unit of energy saved, as Nitin Gadkari ji often says, is equal to 1.33 units of energy produced. So we bring down carbon consumption, energy consumption, and the electricity bills of our consumers. That project was launched. A month and a half after that, I had gone to the Prime Minister to report and discuss some coal auction projects and what the progress was. I was at his residence early morning, 9 o'clock. We finished the discussion on the coal auction. I just got up to leave. And the Prime Minister says, Piyush, abhi tak kitne bulb bike hai? I was jolted. I am the minister handling, you know, several portfolios. I didn't know how many bulbs had been sold till that date. I said, sir, main pata karke aapko batata hun. He said, baitho. And then I got, Adil Bhai, I've been in business. I've been a management student for over 3 decades before I became a minister. But I got my biggest lesson of management from the Honorable Prime Minister that morning. He asked me to sit down and he said, Piyush, projects cannot be executed like this. You will not be successful unless you are hands-on on the project. Monitoring and accountability will determine the fate of your project, the success of your project. Achhi nigrani rakhoge, to aap jimmedari thehra sakoge, kiska kaam theek hai, kaun kaam theek nahi kar raha hai. Jimmedari thehrani hai, to nigrani zaruri hai. And that day was like a wake-up call for me. I came out from his residence. Within a week, we had the Ujala dashboard up and about. And from that day to today, on a 30-second or one-minute basis, on real time, the nation knows how many LED bulbs EESL has sold in the country and how many LED bulbs on a monthly basis the private sector is selling. And as against the target of 77 crores in 4.5 years, the country actually achieved, between government and the private sector put together, over 150 crore bulbs in 4.5 years. I doubt you will get an incandescent bulb in the marketplace today, even if you were to go out and search for it. If at all you'll get it, you'll get an antique piece which will be priced at 1,000 rupees. There will be an antique piece or a designer piece. LED prices came down by 85%, became affordable for every citizen of India. And we've saved millions of tons of carbon dioxide every year. We've saved billions of units of electricity consumption. And our consumers are saving anywhere between 40 and 50,000 crores for the bulb sold both by the private sector and the government company ESL. Lessons such as these are abundant in your document that you have presented to us today. And I'm sure our engineers, our project management teams can learn a lot as we implement the 103 crore national infrastructure pipeline that the Honorable Prime Minister has approved, that is now in public domain, and which will be the cornerstone of India's rapid recovery in the post-COVID world. In railways also, where we have a current year target of 1.62 lakh crore of capex, we are using a number of management principles and good management, project management practices, like prioritizing projects, using our scarce resources judiciously, focusing on high density routes, freight routes, last mile connectivity projects, port connectivity projects, projects to the coal mines, projects where our farmers can benefit through Kisan Rail. And we have identified 58 supercritical and 68 critical projects which are of strategic importance, which in the next 4 years we shall complete, and which will significantly enhance our capacity to serve passengers and freight. Similarly, we are constantly innovating with newer practices, doing a grassroots root cause analysis approach to resolve problems, doing a lot of monitoring exercise, and ensuring that we once again get the railway project implementation of track. Gone are the days where projects would take 50 years to implement. You know, we have a project in West Bengal, which was started in 1974. And till today, we are not able to complete it. It's half done in bits and pieces. Just like Honorable Gadkariji guided, Honorable Prime Minister guided, now we don't take up a project till we have the full land in our control. And once we have the land, then we start implementing the projects. Similarly, we are looking at innovative ways of financing projects. We are looking at going more and more for EPC projects. And I'm also working, just like we did in power, where in transmission projects, Power Grid had to bid along with all private sector and be in competition and earn their projects. No nomination of projects. We found Power Grid became more efficient. Cost came down by 15 to 20%. And we were able to save for the nation thousands of crores of rupees. Similarly, in railways, we are now trying to get all our PSUs to compete with the private sector and stand on their own legs. No more nomination, EPC projects, which will help everybody to compete and make the best company win. I'm really grateful to all of you for showing us the right way to manage projects efficiently, to bring excellence in project management and truly make planning the bulwark for the future of efficiency and energize the infrastructure system. In conclusion, I can only quote Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who said, "Excellence is a continuous process and not an accident." While on the one hand, I'm happy to share with you, in the last 18 months in the Indian Railways, not a single passenger has died because of a railway accident, not a single passenger. And I pray to God to continue to bless our country, the railways, and our passengers with his benevolence and protect the safety of our passengers. We on our part will continue to focus a lot on safety, but let's make project execution also a continuous process. Let us all work together under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to truly make project implementation India's strength and take Indian infrastructure to new heights of glory. Thank you very much for your patience. Namaskar.